Have you ever wanted to make a game, but your computer is basically a potato? Or maybe you just really don't want to code that much? Well, GameMaker might be your new best friend. So in this episode, let's take a look at GameMaker. But before that, this will be my first time using it, so if I screw anything up, feel free to roast me in the comments. The first thing I noticed is the pricing. The engine itself is free to install, which is nice. But if you want to actually sell your game, yeah, that will cost you. You will need to pay $100 upfront for a commercial license. And if you're fancy and want the big league features like console exports or source code access, there's an enterprise license that costs $800 a year. Now, to be fair, this pricing is pretty straightforward. You don't have to pay until you are ready to publish, but here's the catch. It is not exactly indie dev friendly. If you're a beginner just trying to go through the publishing process, even if you know your game won't make a cent, you still have to cough up that $100. Meanwhile, engines like Unity and Unreal, they are like, don't worry about money until you actually make some. That's a much friendlier deal for indies who just want to learn how publishing works. And don't forget, stores like Steam also charge you $100. So with GameMaker, you are already $200 in the hole before your game sees the light of day. That's not exactly beginner friendly. Sure, it is a one-time fee, which is cool. But for new devs on a tight budget, that could be a deal breaker. But the good news? The system requirements. Basically non-existent. It runs on 2GB RAM and a hard drive from 2010. You could probably run it on a toaster. So I went ahead and installed it. It's available for Windows, macOS, and even Ubuntu. And here's a surprise. I found out you can use GameMaker not just to make games, but also live wallpapers and something called game strips. No clue what that is. Maybe it's connected to the Opera browser or something. Anyway, I'm here for the games. We can start with a blank project or pick a template. And I have to say, the template games look visually great, especially for kids. Let's try platformer template and here it is. Wow, this thing looks pretty polished from the menu to the environment to the UI. It's clean. It's like Mario, but with a pig. So let's call it Pigario. So where's the code? Where's all the stuff that makes this thing run? I don't see anything at first glance. Maybe they are in the asset browser. Ah, yes, here are the project files. Wow, the animations are really well done and the windows are draggable around the workspace. I like it. There are object files too, which I am guessing store info about the game assets. And the whole UI? It feels super futuristic, kinda like blueprint system in Unreal Engine. You can even create variables using a visual interface, which is nice if you are not super into writing code. But I picked the scripting option, not visual. So again, where's the code? Found it. It's written in GameMaker language or GML. Its syntax is heavily inspired by C or C++. We've got curly braces, semicolons at end of each statement, just like in C. That's actually a plus, because a lot of people start learning programming with C. So if you're already comfortable with that, learning GML won't be too hard. Oh, and I also found an animation player. It reminds me of the one in Godot. But honestly, I think this one looks a bit more visually appealing. Just my opinion though, what do you think? So, who is GameMaker for? Well, it's studio only and you will need to pay if you want to publish. So I'd say it's perfect for kids, hobbyists or devs who are 100% focused on 2D games. But if you plan to go 3D one day, this probably isn't your engine. Unless you enjoy switching engines and relearning everything from scratch. Sure, some core game dev concepts carry over, but the UI, workflow and scripting language, all different. Still, don't underestimate this engine. Games like Spelunky, Kubu the Tree Spirit and Fishbowl were all made with GameMaker.